Hello everyone. Today I am going to be doing my mini twist. Today is Thursday, September 8th, and I'm finally getting around to doing my mini twist. I'm so happy. I'm so excited to finally put the style in my hair. I can honestly say in the past I used to dread doing mini twists because they take like 5 hours when I do like the micro mini twist, and that's what I plan on doing. Well, we'll see when I start twisting. I might be like, eh, nope. I just washed my hair and it probably only took me about 10-15 minutes to wash my hair because obviously I did not section my hair when I washed it. Today was just one of those days when I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna wash it because it really doesn't matter anyway. I'm gonna be twisting it and styling it. It's not like I'm just leaving it out like this. My hair is a bit shorter. As you can see, I did cut my hair. It's probably about 6 to 7 inches long. In some places it might be 8, but mostly throughout my hair is 6 to 7 inches long, which is about where I started when I first started my hair journey back in 2014, or I should say when I got like really serious about it. So I'm pretty much back where I started, maybe like an inch or two longer, but it's about the same length. So yeah, let me go ahead and get started. So I'm thinking it'll probably be about this size. Like, this is the amount of hair that I'm going to use for each twist. It might be a little bit bigger than that. We'll see. Because honestly, when I style my hair, so I'm supposed to be doing a chit chat, but obviously I'm treating this like it's a tutorial or something, but it's not. But usually when I style my twists, mini twists, I kind of cheat a little bit. And what I do is the ones that show, they're the smaller ones, and the ones that really don't show, they're kind of bigger than the other twists. So the ones that show, they will be true micro mini twists. Right now it is 6:20, so hopefully I will be done by midnight. So what I've been doing, or what I am doing right now, is just spraying my hair with water. And this is just a water bottle right here. It's just lukewarm water because I do not like spraying my hair with cold water. Cannot stand that feeling. I am taking a little bit of whipped shea butter that I made. It's actually a blend of some other oils and shea butter, and I'm just using that, and that's it. I'm not doing the lock method or the LCO method. Like, I'm not doing all of that because, one, I do not want a lot of product buildup on my hair. That's like the most annoying thing, because I feel like I have to wash my hair more often when I put too many products on my hair. And I still do the lock method or the LCO method either every day or every other day. I know a lot of people say that they only do it you know, once a week or whenever they wash their hair, maybe twice a week. But I'm like, really? Like, my hair, I have tried so many products and my hair just needs to be done. Like, it needs to be moisturized and, you know, moisturized and sealed on a daily, or, you know, bi-daily, or every other day, you know. So I'm actually going to be getting up in a few minutes to make dinner, but I wanted to at least start on the back. I think I'll do this whole row back here, which will maybe take me about 30. I got a little too excited. I said 30 minutes here, right? Maybe I'll get halfway through it and then I'll go make some dinner. I'll just kind of pay attention to my hair and my scalp. I'll just listen to them to see when they need to be washed. So it might be once a week, it might be once every 2 weeks, but you know, the weather's starting to change, it's starting to transition into fall. So my regimen does switch up a little bit more, but this time around, I'm honestly just going to listen to my hair and my scalp and see what they need. And I know a lot of people are like, what does that mean? Listen to your hair, listen to your scalp. Like I said, it's just paying attention to it. Your hair, your scalp, really your body, they give you signs, you know? When something's not right, or when something needs to be fixed or changed, or when something's good, your body will let you know. So I just pay attention to my hair and my scalp. So, you know, that's what I do, and then that will determine like, oh, it's time for me to wash my hair, or my hair needs to be deep conditioned, or it needs to be moisturized. Like, I'm at that point where I can, you know, figure out when it's time for that to happen, when it's time for all those things to happen to my hair. But yeah, I keep getting, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry guys, I keep getting distracted. What I was saying, what is it, the third time I'm trying to tell you guys this? Yeah, so I'm just using these two products. I'm just using these two products because the product buildup, and also to, I want to get to the point where I'm using the least amount of products as possible on my hair. I'm at the point where I have tried dozens and dozens and dozens of different brands and probably 100 different products just over, you know, the course of my lifetime, probably more than that, probably more than 100 different products. So I'm at the point now where I know my hair. I don't feel like I need to do, you know, too much to it. There's nothing that I feel like I need to change. I feel good about my hair. I feel good about my regimen. I feel good about, you know, the attention I give my hair. Like, I feel really good about it all. So I don't feel the need to, you know, do too much. I've learned over the years that the simpler, the better for my hair. And so if I'm not piling down too much to my hair, like I mentioned, I won't have to wash it as much. I won't have to really do too much with it, but just enjoy the break from doing my hair. And then too, I feel like it'll just, you know, help my hair to really flourish, and it'll really benefit my hair in the long run. Because even though I just cut my hair, I actually want to grow it back out. Like, I only cut it, one, because I really did want to cut my hair. Like, I really wanted to cut my hair. And I know for some of y'all, my hair probably still looks the same. Like, the length of it probably still looks the same. But my hair, again, my hair is very dense. So it's kind of hard to know when I cut my hair unless it's just a drastic change. If I were to chop off like 8 to 10 inches, obviously you would know. But because my hair is still dense and does have a lot of shrinkage, it still looks the same. I started off trimming my hair because my hair desperately needed a trim. Like, it really needed a trim. And I noticed that I usually trim my hair every 3 months. I don't have a set schedule, but it usually falls every 3 months is when I have to trim my hair. I trimmed it, but then I got excited because I'm like, hey, when the scissors get in my hand, I get excited, and I love cutting hair. Not like professionally or anything like that. If I was a hairstylist, you probably would not like me, because I would be that one that just gets excited about cutting hair. And you'd probably be like, well, I just need a little trim. And I probably take off like more than I should. Not because like I'm being, you know, cruel or mean or jealous or anything like that, but just because, I don't know, something about like cutting hair is just so much fun. So yeah, I would be that stylist that would be cutting your hair off right now if I could. This chit chat thing is hard, guys, because I keep getting distracted. And so it turned into a little cut because I've been wanting to cut my hair anyway. I honestly have wanted to do like a drastic change. I've wanted to do like the tapered fro, where it's kind of low on like the sides and then the back, and then the rest is like long. So then that way I could still have some kind of length up here, you know, something still to play around with, but not as much. So I wanted to do that haircut. That would be something I would honestly get done professionally. I would think that I would get down professionally, but knowing me, I'd probably just take care of it myself. I'd probably just do it at home. And there's somebody, I think her name is Miss Alexandra Nicole, or I think that's her name, Miss Alexandra Nicole. And if you follow her on Instagram, I'm not sure if she has a YouTube channel or not, but her Instagram pictures, her hair is beautiful. That's the cut that I love. I love her haircut. It's so pretty. But I will put her Instagram name below, but I believe it's Miss Alexandra Nicole. I have always been very specific about the kind of music that I listen to. Even growing up, like, I didn't listen to everything. Like, when I was younger, my mom pretty much controlled what I listened to. And I say that because her and I mean, we shared a room when I was growing up, up until like my teenage years. Her and I actually shared a room. And obviously I didn't play everything I wanted to hear. I used to have to hide CDs, you know, certain CDs from my mom. I actually remember, like, my mom keeps a very, very, very clean house. Like, extremely clean house. And I remember one time I had bought the Usher CD, or somebody had gave it to me when I was in school. So I hid it under the couch, like underneath the couch was dirty or messy or something. There was nothing underneath the couch, but I hid it under there. And I don't know why, of all places, that's where I hid it. But I, again, because we shared a room, I couldn't really hide it in my room. Cause you know, that would just seem easy for her to just find anything. So I hid it under the couch. And of course, she cleans very regularly. And so she checked under the couch, and lo and behold, there was Usher CD. I think it was Nice and Slow. You know, the one, the cover, he's like in all black with his little black scully on, looking up with his little gold chain or whatever that was around his neck. And, you know, so I kind of got in trouble for having that. I think I was like in the sixth grade maybe at the time. And then there was another time when I was a little older, I had a Lil' Kim CD. And yeah, that one was a little explicit. But I had that CD, I think I was like 14 or something. I had one of her CDs, my mom found it. And it was so funny because we got in the house, me and my brother got home from school, my mom just so happened to be home. And then she's like, I want y'all to hear something real quick. And I'm like, oh, okay. And she literally starts playing this Lil' Kim CD. And I was like, oh my gosh. Like, oh my goodness, mom. You know, and it's funny because it's like, you can listen to it, but then when your parents listen to it, it just is like really awkward and uncomfortable. And you know, it's just like, turn it off, like just turn it off. And I can't even remember what song it was, but I mean, you know Lil' Kim, so you know, she gives it to you the way, you know, the way it happens. And even in the car growing up, you know, my mom was very careful about the music that, you know, she played around my brother and I. She played a lot of gospel music. Every now and then, I mean, she played Toni Braxton, but I think when I got like a little bit older, she just stopped playing it altogether. So I grew up listening to mainly gospel. But all that to say, that has, you know, taught me to appreciate good music and not to just, you know, let anything and everything play, you know, and not to just listen to anything and everything, because everything that's played on the radio is not good music. I've been thinking lately how much I've been listening to like the same artists for such a long time. I'm such a dedicated fan, well, supporter of these artists, but I'm like, I need to listen to some more artists out there. And I love, you know, neo soul. Like my favorite artist is Corinne Bailey Rae. She's my absolute favorite artist. I love her music so much. I have every CD of hers. I also like Floetry. I wish they would make another album together. Their music is just amazing. Amazing. I love their music. In terms of gospel music, because I do listen to a lot of gospel music, but I listen to like a lot of what they call like Christian hip hop or gospel hip hop. So I listen to a lot of Lecrae, Andy Mineo, Triply, KB. Those are the main ones that I listen to. But I meet more artists, guys. Oh yeah. So I finished this back row already. As you can see, I'm not gonna count, but it looks like maybe about 25 to 30, no more than 30 are back there. And let's see the time and see how long it took me. So right now it is 6:43, so it took me about 20 minutes to just do that back section right there. But going back to the music, like I really want to find some other artists because I'm just kind of ready to expand, but I don't want to listen to just anything. Like I've already told you, I love Corinne Bailey Rae, I love Floetry, I love Lauryn Hill. You know, those are the type of artists that I really listen to. And I don't want to spend like, oh my gosh, look how small that one is. This is gonna take a long time. A lot of artists too, I start liking their music, or you know, I like their beats more so. You know, I really like their beats, as you know, most people do. Then in the beginning, I really like their song and what they're about, but I'm not big on cussing. Like, And there are so many rappers too where I know they have such a good message, but I just cannot get past the cussing. I don't know, it's probably just me, but yeah, I just can't do the cussing. So if it's too much, you know, I'm like, let me turn it off. I mean, I can deal with like, you know, a word here and there, depending on which word it is, I can deal with it, but I'm not big on hearing, you know, all of that, every other word or every other sentence. I'm just not big on it at all. I'll leave some people below if you have anyone that you think I might like. please leave them below. Well, you know, my birthday is in a couple of weeks, so I have been trying to decide if I want to wear a mini twist or if I want to wear my own hair out. I'm not doing a wig. That is not an option for me right now, especially since I'm trying to grow out those little areas that I mentioned in one of my other videos, my current hair issues video. I'm thinking I might just wear the twists. You know, I might just refresh them the night before, because I am not going to work on my birthday. I have decided from here on out, I do not go to work on my birthday. So last year was the last time that I have done that, but here on out, nope. And my supervisor has already approved, so you'll see. That's why I love mini twists, because they have the movement. I love that. I just love that movement, and they fall so good. Like, they just look so good. Anyway, so I was thinking, I have so many dresses. Like, I wish I could show you guys my closet right now, but so I probably have about 60 dresses. I'm gonna count them and I'm gonna let you know. I'm gonna put the number right here randomly. I'm gonna tell you how many dresses I have. But I have a lot of dresses, and I had the nerve to be online today and even yesterday, really this whole week, trying to figure out what I'm going to wear for my birthday. Looking at dresses, like, I need to go out and buy another dress. Like, I'm trying to get so much better. I'm wearing a dress right now. Trying to get so much better about, you know, my spending and everything. And I'm up here looking at dresses, but I didn't buy it. I didn't buy anything, so I'm actually happy about that. Okay, so see, this one's a little thicker than the other ones. I think the other ones were probably about like half of that. The other ones were like that small, but this one is double that. So, and because it won't be seen, I am going to go ahead and keep it that size. And I'll probably do most of this row like that, just to kind of, you know, make time go by a little faster. If you have not followed me on Instagram, please do, the 4C Project. I would love to have, you know, you guys come check me out over there. I post up there more than I do anywhere else. So definitely check out my Instagram, the 4C Project. And I love interacting with you guys. So if you leave comments or ask me questions, I always, well, I'm not gonna say always, but I respond to probably like 98 to 99% of you guys. Even when you send me DMs, I do. But you know, everything is not appropriate. So if I don't respond, it's either because you left me an inappropriate comment, or I just didn't see it. And usually if I don't see it, if I do see it and it's like 20 weeks later, I will still respond. Like, I honestly do. Right now I'm at 10,000 on Instagram, a little over 10,000. I'm so thankful for that. I have not said thank you yet on Instagram, and there's a reason why. But I do want to say thank you so much, you guys, for allowing the 4C Project to get to 10,000 followers, as they call it. But you know, you're my Insta fam, is what I like to call you guys. But thank you so much for helping. Let me stop because I'm getting distracted. Thank you so much for helping the 4C Project get there. And this is not just about me. It's not just about my kinky hair. It's about you and your kinky hair. So I am just beyond excited that we have made it this far and that we're only going to continue to grow. So I'm really just thankful for the opportunities that are going to come up that will include you guys. And I will make sure to always give you guys, you know, recognition and shout you guys out and everything like that, because it's because of you following me and liking me and whatever else that, you know, I have that number behind me. You know, I mean, it's not all about the numbers at the end of the day. It's really not, but it's just exciting to see that, you know, that many people support the 4C Project, and it makes me really excited. So thank you guys so much. So I don't even know what I was talking about. I'll tell you, this chit chat thing is harder than it seems. It really is harder than it seems. And if you're just curious, I do not part my hair. I just grab and go. And it still doesn't look that bad. Like, it doesn't look, you know, messed up or uneven too much, but I just grab and go. I don't part. That just takes too long, way too long. I am loving this shea butter right now. Gosh, I just love it. My hair just loves shea butter. I know, it's so funny to me. It's a lot of people who do not like coconut oil and who do not like shea butter. But those two are just, oh my gosh, they just do so much goodness for my hair. Like, they just do so much for my hair. And I absolutely love them both. My hair loves them both too. Like, it's just enjoying this hairstyle right now. It's not giving me any problems. I can easily detangle my hair. My hair is just loving it. It really is. My hair, this is my head straight on. This is my collarbone. So I'm probably, what, maybe an inch or a little longer than that. Let me see. Actually, I'm a couple inches. I'm probably like 2 inches past that. So, but I am not at the armpit, which that is probably about, armpit is probably, it's gonna have this striped dress on right now. Armpit is probably at this stripe right here. Set like this one for me. And my hair is right at this one. So that's cool that I have this dress on right now. So I'm this far away from reaching the armpit. We'll see how long it takes me to get there. So I have this much left. Y'all can see how dense my hair is. Look at that. But I have this much to do in the back. And then I'll pretty much be halfway done just about. I mean, yeah, I'll be like, well, maybe like one more little row will make me halfway done. So that's not bad at all. And right now my stopping time is 7:15. So less than an hour, I was able to do as much as I did. It might not look like a lot, but yeah, that's pretty good. So less than an hour. And it's got the body. I love the body. It's 7:58. And I just took my 30 minute break, like I'm at work or something. But I don't know why I took those down. I took a little 30 minute break and took care of something real quick. And now I'm going to finish up this section right here. I actually have to leave in about 30 minutes to go run out and do something. So it's not a big deal that I leave the house like this. Like, trust me, it's not. It's nighttime right now, and I don't even have to get out of the car, but just going to the car. And then when I get home, I get out of the car, and that's it. So I won't be like walking around the store or anything like that. So I'll be fine to just walk out, you know, with this like in a little puff, and then it'd be twisting the back. Anyway, let me go ahead and get started. See how I ramble on it. I did have a YouTube channel back in the day. I used to do videos and stuff like that, and I used to love making videos back then. My first one was in 2009, and I kept that channel up for about a year. And I obviously talked about natural hair, and then when I had got, when I Tex-Lax my hair, well, actually, you know, relaxed it and ended up turning out Tex-Lax versus relaxed. When I did that, I didn't feel like I really had anything to kind of contribute to the natural hair community, so I just, deleted my channel. And I actually remember getting an email from one girl. There were actually a couple people, but I remember her email specifically. She had messaged me on YouTube and was like, something along the lines of, it's disappointing to see that you have put a chemical in your hair because you could have offered so much to the natural hair community. It was something like that. Like, you know, I'm disappointed, or, you know, sad that you did that to your hair because, you know, you were an influence or an inspiration or something in the natural hair community, something along those lines. So honestly, when I read that, I was kind of sad. I was like, oh, what am I done? And I think immediately after that, I was just like, you know what, that just, you know, sealed the deal. I really have nothing to offer to the natural hair community anymore. So I deleted my channel. But anyways, I just want to tell you guys that I want to do more on this channel. Please don't think I am trying to not be consistent on this channel. Like, I'm not trying my best. I'm going to admit that. But I am trying to do better on this channel and try to post more. The issue is, well, it's actually a couple issues. One thing is my camera. My camera is fine. Don't get me wrong, but I do want a camera with better quality so that I can give you guys more videos, because right now I'm kind of holding back on a few videos. Like, I have quite a few videos. Like, I have a list okay? A list, a long list of videos that I want to make, but most of them require, I don't want to say they require me to have a better camera, but it would be best if I had a camera with better quality just so I can show you guys certain things. Because, you know, I mean, let's be real. My camera is 6 years old. There will be some videos I will not do yet until I get another camera because I have a vision for some of these videos. Like, I'm serious. I have a vision for some of these and how I want it to be and what I want to show and how I want it to go and everything. So when I get that camera, it's gonna happen. I am okay with the software that I use now. Like, it's not a major thing for me to upgrade to new software right now. If I had a new camera, I would still be using that same little movie maker that I use right now because I don't feel like spending too much money right now on editing software. I told myself that if I become, you know, really consistent with this channel, along with a few other things, then I would upgrade, you know, pretty much just about everything. But right now I'm gonna start off with the camera first and then see how that goes for me before I kind of reward myself or buy anything else for this channel. But the other things are my laptops. So one of my laptops I've had for probably 6 years as well. It's a little small one. It's like a little 10-inch. It's so cute. It's so small. I can't put the screen like all the way up. Like once I put it all the way up, it goes black. But if I like bend it like this, like at this kind of angle, it will be on. Like the screen will be on. But I'm not gonna be sitting right here typing or trying to edit a video with the screen like this. But when I go like that, like normal, it goes black. So I don't know, all you IT people out there, what does that mean? I mean, I have no clue what that means. Other one I was using when I was recording or editing my last videos, I was using that one, which is technically my husband's, but the screen has kind of disconnected from the actual keyboard part, if that makes sense. Like, they're connected on one side, but on the other side, it's broken. So that has caused some issues. You know how the screen and the keyboard part meet? Well, on one side, it's connected. On the other side, it lifts. Like, it's pretty much broken to the point where I can't even get internet on that laptop. And then the other one I have, which I've had for about 4 years, what's the issue with that one? It's slow. But it's got a lot better. It's a little slow. So right now I'm using the one that's like kind of broken on one side. I'm using that one to edit. Then I transfer it over to the other one that's kind of slow just to, you know, save it, I think. I don't know. I can't even think. It's just too many steps. Like, let me just put it that way. It's too many steps. I do want to do more with this channel. I'm not being lazy with it. I'm just trying to do what I can, you know, with the resources that I currently have. But I'm gonna get consistent when I can, I promise you guys, because I actually want to do YouTube. Like, I want to do more on YouTube so I can continue to just, you know, inspire you guys and keep you motivated and excited about your natural hair journey, your healthy hair journey, your hair journey, whatever you want to call it. I want to keep you guys excited about it all. I'm probably about a third of the way finished, which is great. Let me check my time. Uh-oh, forgot to check my time. It is now, it's 8:24. Yep, y'all can see that. It's 8:24 right now, and I actually have to leave. I'm just gonna take one of these little clips. Let me at least find a white one or a black one. I'm not going out with a pink one. Where are my black ones at? Because this white one even looks a little odd. Whatever, it's nighttime. I'm putting this together like I'm going to prom or something. Trying to style it like I'm about to go somewhere and do something. All right, guys, so I'm on the last section here. And it's actually not as late as I thought it was going to be. It is, let's see. Sorry. It's 11:31 right now. And I started on it about 10 o'clock, so I'm an hour and a half in. It only took me an hour and a half to do the rest of the section, believe it or not. I watched some very interesting videos, so that definitely helped make the time fly by. But yeah, I'm on the last section. I will be done well before 12 o'clock, so I'm not sure the exact hours that I put into doing this hairstyle. I'll think about it, I've calculated everything. But it didn't take as long as I thought. I honestly, even though I said 12 o'clock, I honestly thought it was gonna be like maybe 12:30, 1 o'clock when I would be done. But yeah, so I'm at the final end of this and it's very exciting. So let me scoot up a little bit more. There we go. All right, so I end up doing a side part. It's over here, it's kind of like slanted a little bit, and I just parted with my finger. I didn't grab out the comb or anything like that. But yeah, so I'm almost done. I'm so excited. You all see like my gray hair, my silver strands is what I really like to call them. I love them. Like, they are really, really shining today. So are you the type that, you know, likes your gray hair, your silver strands, your platinum strands, whatever you like to call them? Do you like them or do you dye them? Because you just don't, you know, care for that right now. Personally, I don't mind. I've never dyed my hair. That's probably one thing I probably won't ever do. Like, I don't have any interest in dyeing my hair a different color because, I don't know, I'm just not interested in it. Not interested in it at all. I actually like my dark brown hair, and I do have natural brown reddish highlights, so like a sandy brown. I do have those natural color highlights in my hair. You can't really see them up, you know, like right now you can't really see them, but like, you know, when I'm outside in the sun you can really see them. And yeah, they're really pretty too. So, and my husband likes to call me his redhead because you can really see the red, like during the summertime you can really see it. So thank you guys for chit-chatting with me today and listening to me ramble about whatever. I don't even remember what I talked about, but thanks so much for sticking with me and making this go by super fast. I really appreciate it. Oh my gosh, they are so cute. They are so cute. See, if I knew how to do makeup really well, this is where I would put on my full face and take my 2 hours to put on makeup just so I can do those cute little poses that all the YouTubers do. You know, it's like when they get done doing something, they're always like, they always do look down and then look up and stare into the camera and change the angles and then do the same thing on the other side and then they put the little hand up. Y'all know how they do. Y'all know how they all do. But anyways, I am loving these twists. I'm very pleased with the results. They look really, really good. Yeah, they look really good. So this is how they look up close. And the other side. Thank you guys so much for joining me today. I'm tired. I don't even know what I'm talking about. Y'all just have a great night, okay? I'll see you in my next video. Bye.